you maybe like most speakers, most women speakers say, you know, I just want to be authentic. I want to be authentic and real and be able to speak from the heart. Yeah. Well, I do too. When you're speaking from a stage, whether it be virtual or in person, you can end up saying things that maybe you regret. Have you ever said something that you wish you could take back? Like, you know, whether it be in a conversation or from a stage or even online, like a Facebook Live or something like that. I know I have, and it's not fun. It just feels awful when that happens. And I find that most often the women speakers that do this, so I'm talking about women speakers because that's who I work with, women entrepreneurs who are just emerging women speakers. Most often when you do that is because you're not versed in a structure. You don't have a proven structure by which to speak. What do I mean by that? I'm Lisa Vanderkwaak, the CEO and founder of the Emerging Women's Speakers Community and the Speak to Transform Academy. You may be like most speakers, most women speakers say, you know, I just want to be authentic. I want to be authentic and real and be able to speak from the heart. Yeah, well, I do too. I do too. And in fact, yes, I want you to be authentic. I want you to speak with authenticity and realness. But did you know that you can speak from the heart, speak authentically, but if you want it to be effective and impactful and bring you to a place of being seen as a person of authority in whatever area of influence you are, whether it be a business or ministry or subject matter, then you also need to be able to speak within the guidelines of a framework, a structure, a set of understanding of what it is that you're trying to accomplish, who it is you're speaking to, and a way to reach the goals that you have. If you just speak from whatever comes out of your mouth, then most often you may actually end up saying things that you regret or that may get you in hot water. And on social media, you want to avoid that for sure, because as you know, people can be vicious. And even when you say all the right things and with well intentions, people can still take it the wrong way. So this is why it's so important for you to be prepared, but also to learn a proven structure. Now, I know, first of all, when I say that, a lot of people say, oh, structure, that I don't want to be boxed in. I'm not trying to box you in. I'm actually trying to give you more freedom. When I first learned how to downhill ski, I had to learn how to position my body, how to make my knees soft and position my legs so that I was a bit like I was kneeling, not kneeling, bending my knees a bit. My feet had to be a certain way. My skis had to be positioned a certain way. I had to learn all this in order if I wanted to go down the slope safely and also in the direction that I wanted to. But I had to do that first, and I had to do that a number of times until it became second nature. I no longer had to think about it. It just became second nature. Only then could I go down the slopes with freedom and creativity and add my style into it. And maybe, yeah, veer off to the right or to the left without going into the bushes. Because now I had a mechanism by which I had trained myself to stay within a certain boundaries and to adjust when I needed to adjust, because I had taken the time to learn a proven way, a systematic way of learning how to ski and how to get down the slopes. But it gave me freedom because I learned and I had that built in. The same is true for public speaking. You may not realize it, but actually, whether it be doing Facebook Lives, going on summits, speaking in person, or giving a talk to a group online or a webinar, if you don't already have a proven structure to communicate your message, you may find it to be less effective. And I want you to have freedom. I want you to be authentic, but I want you to speak with authority and with confidence and clarity and impact. So I want to invite you to take advantage of the one-day training that I'm offering. If you have a message and you know you're not getting the results that you want from it, or that you really don't know a proven structure to be able to put together your message so that you can speak more authentically, you can engage more with your audience, that you're free to bring in your own style and your own personality, then I want to encourage you to take in my one-day training. The link is up above, and I would love to see you there. But listen, this is the time and the era that women, godly women, are being called to the stages of the world. And it's not a time to shrink back. It's actually a time to step forward with confidence and clarity and learn the skills that you need to learn in order to be the voice of influence that you're called to. So you need to be willing to learn the skills and to add to your assets the things you need in order to be able to be the influence and to stay visible in a way that's going to impact the lives of the people that you're called to speak to. Because you have a message that needs to be heard. You have a story that needs to be told, because you are a voice that is meant to be a voice of influence. And as you communicate the message that you have on your heart, the gift that you're meant to give, it will bring transformation, healing, and radical change in people's lives. But you need to be willing to do your part, to do it with everything you have, and to hone that gift and to learn the skills. So I'd love for you to come. I look forward to seeing you on February 6th, the one-day training. This training may be the most important training you're ever going to do this year that will help propel you forward if you want to get on virtual stages and communicate your message, or if you just want to tweak what you're doing and in-person stages as well. Look forward.